Hi, this is Steve Kraus, Chief of Insights for Similarweb, here with another edition of our Weekly Winners, our highly selective look at the trends and brands that won the internet last week. Unless otherwise noted, all data in this video are courtesy of Similarweb, the leader in market intelligence, and show the past 28 days of data in the United States. That's up through Thursday, June 28th, 2018. Let's get it started. First up, some promotional winners of the week. Now, most of the big retail sites are going to have their big sales next week, the week of July 4th, but we saw a number of specialty retailers get in ahead of the curve and have good success with promotional efforts. So we'll take a look at a few. Theoutnet.com had big success with their sale last weekend. As we click over to their site, we see offering an extra 40% off over the weekend leading up to July 4th. Mattress retailers. This has become a very competitive area, especially as some summer starts to arrive. So we saw big jumps for both Casper.com and Leesa.com. As we take a look at their websites, we see both of them featuring big pop-ups on their websites with special promotional efforts or sales leading up to July 4th. The final promotional winner of the week we're going to look at, New York fashion-based retailer RagAndBone.com, with big success based on their sale. As we take a look at their site, up to 65% off. Winner, REI.com. You see strong traffic peaks in the past week as their anniversary sale transitioned into their 4th of July sale. And it's even more impressive when we look at that past 28 days performance in the context of their past year's performance shown here. You see now they're well ahead of where they were a year ago at this time. And in fact, they're even ahead of their December peak, a pattern that we don't often see in retail and a pattern that we didn't see in REI last year. As we've seen the last 3 weeks, the World Cup continues to be a big factor driving digital traffic around the world. This week, we'll take a look at where traffic from the keyword phrase World Cup goes to. We see that about a third of it goes to YouTube, with the top five being rounded out by FIFA.com, TheGuardian.org, FoxSports.com, and Wikipedia.org. If we take a deeper dive into those, what we're going to find is that the really big general sites, places like YouTube, that brings in 800 million visits a day, is really so big and so generalized, you're not going to see a big bump as a result of the start of the World Cup on June 14th. Similarly, if we take a look at Wikipedia, bringing in still a very substantial, peaking at about 200 million visitors a day, again, we don't see a lot of an inflection point there based on the World Cup. We do see more of a day of the week pattern where they peak every Sunday. If we look at The Guardian, the UK publication, that obviously focuses on a lot more than sports, we do see a bit of an inflection point. If we take a look at their traffic before the start of the World Cup on June 14th, very consistently below 10 million visitors a day, and now quite consistently hitting 10 million visitors a day. Now, if we look at some of the other sites that have really gotten a big boost, smaller, more specific sites to the World Cup, there you see big increases in traffic with the start of the World Cup, as we see for FIFA.com or FoxSports.com. Or if we take a look at the Players Tribune, a site where athletes can publish their own work, we see a big jump on Monday, June 18th. We can take a look at our popular pages and see that much of that is driven by an article called "I've Got Something to Say" by Belgian footballer Romelu Lukaku. It was very popular, very widely read. I, of course, figured out how to pronounce Romelu Lukaku by going to the YouTube video for how to pronounce Romelu Lukaku. The final thing I wanted to mention in terms of the World Cup, we have seen some growth in certain apps, whether it's games like the FIFA soccer game app or more of an informational app like OneFootball. That's all for this week. I'm Steve Kraus, Chief of Insights for Similarweb. Until next time, may all your decisions be data-driven.